I'm Greg Hollows. Welcome to the Imaging Lab. In this segment, we're going to look at directional illumination again, but in this time, we're going to talk about things called ring lights. In the last segment, we talked about things that were directional illumination, being spotlights and bar lights, generally coming from one direction all the time. As we can see here with this ring light, we have light that's coming from a circular area, and there's a hole in the middle that we will put our lens and camera system behind, and it'll look through down at an object on the table. Now, the light comes together at some point, at some good distance away, where it's going to create a uniform illumination coming from all directions around the circle. As you can see from the image, you will notice that ring light actually gets away from the directional illumination issues that we saw earlier, where we had a lot of shadowing with our target. You'll notice in this image that there is actually no shadowing in the target, but we still have a tremendous amount of hot spots depending on the actual material that's on the surface of the target itself. If you look at some of the high gloss areas of paint, you'll see some definite hot spots that have been created there. It's very hard to pull out the information from a ring light on those sorts of surfaces. But areas that have some amount of minor topography to them that are generally a matte finish are going to work very, very effectively with this sort of lighting geometry. They come in a variety of sizes, from this is a fairly small one, not terribly small, to much, much larger to cover much larger areas. And the interesting thing about this, if you go back to the segment that we talked about with the introduction to lighting, we talked about the W. In the W, lighting that's inside this area where the light would come off of a mirrored surface and go into the lens, anything that's in between the lens itself and that, the light is going to be reflected up and be seen. That would be a bright field scenario for that lighting source. In this sort of scenario, this ring light being up this high where the lens would be put right behind it, we would have a bright field scenario for our object. So if we were to look down at a mirrored surface, as seen in the image above me, you would actually see the ring light here that would be coming up with the individual spots from the LEDs themselves. That could be good, that could be bad, depending on the application. There are other types of ring lights that can look a lot like this, but with the angle of the illumination being very, very low, we would end up with the light sort of very close to the object and the lens still a great distance away. In that sort of scenario, we'd have lighting coming in at a low angle outside the W, and we'd actually be able to not see the lighting at all unless there was a scratch or some sort of other defect on the surface. That would be good for looking at, say, a CD plastic material that's been in some sort of injection molding process that's supposed to be highly reflective, and there's some scratch or other dig that might be on there. Glass surfaces that are supposed to be done to a fine finish, metal and metallic surfaces that are supposed to be to a fine polish. So these sorts of lights can be used very effectively for that, but generally only really good for flat surfaces. These are ring lights. The next segment we'll look at some more advanced geometry of lights that would allow us to look at curved surfaces and other highly reflective areas. You can click on any of the links to take you to the lighting area that you wish to look at or any of the other imaging topics that are of interest to you.